Hello, friends. It feels like it's been a long time since I've done any sewing on this channel. First off, I'm going to be going to my very first reenactment in like 3 weeks. I am pretty excited, actually. But before I do that, I have my Civil War wardrobe that I've been working on since like last year. But there's just a few things that I kind of want to change or add just to make it that much better before I take it to my first real event. So we're going to get right into doing that. So it'll be lots of fun little projects, just like mixing and mending, and hopefully give you some inspiration if you've got any of those type of projects just lying in your closet that need a button here or a zipper there or something like that. Okay, so first off, let's just admire this amazing trunk. Okay, let's just do that. I love this trunk. Now let's open it up. We're gonna look through some of my wardrobe, what I wanna fix. Okay, here we go, is my big and only petticoat. I have it being tied with ties that go, they like go round twice around it. And the issue is sometimes it'll like fall down a little bit, then I'll end up like dragging or stepping on it. But I decided I might put like three hooks and eyes to make it a hook and eye closure. And just keep it that much more stable, staying up on my waist from actually moving around. And now speaking of petticoats, that is another thing I wanna make. So while this petticoat is really big, well, really big in my definition, I wanna make one that's smaller, one that's the under petticoat, because in the Civil War era, a woman would have worn multiple petticoats, like at least, so one would have been really rare. So I'm gonna make another one, just a smaller, slimmer, really simple one that just goes, you know, under this one. Okay, of course I have my lovely chemise and drawers that have served me wonderfully. I have a nice corset that I ordered from Treadle Treasures on Etsy. And if you wanna get a really inexpensive corset, but that's still good quality, please check out her Etsy page. Let's see, I don't really have much else. I got my cute little cap. I do have a bonnet around here somewhere. So here is my aforementioned bonnet. It is quite cute, but the shape isn't really very accurate. Like, it's too kind of broad out to the side. So if I get around to it, I'm thinking of shaping this in sugar water. Hopefully won't affect all the glue. I know glue is not historical, but I glued it. Shaping this historically to more like a this kind of shape. Also, I think I might put some, to get a smooth line from your corset line to like your shoulder, they would put padding like here and here. And I may put that, tack some of that into my dress to create more of a historical silhouette. Anyways, all that to be said, let's get sewing, right? Okay guys, the first one we are working on is gonna be this hat. Whether or not this is wise and whether or not I've done enough research is to be concluded. So I know there's sugar water, like boiling a hat in sugar water to replace it. I mean, to reshape it, but then I've also seen a lot of stuff about steaming. And I figure I'll start with steaming, and if for some reason that's just not cutting it, I can do something a little bit more aggressive. So, lots of very steamy water here, which I'm actually gonna shut off. And I think I'm gonna try just saturating the hat in steam. And here we go. Don't really know what I'm doing. So it's getting floppy, and I put it on my metal hat head thing. I don't know what you want to call it. Anyways, obviously if it's plastic, I may or may not do this because steam is pretty hot. It's metal, so I'm pretty chill with that. Now the shape I'm going for is a much more of an 1860s kind of look, so more of the forward. And that's what I'm going to try to do with my hat here. Thank you. Okay, on to the next project. I just got back from work and I thought, why not at least start jumping into this? And that next project is going to be, woohoo, you guessed it, the petticoat. I'm going to be using a cotton bed sheet. I can't promise this is 100% cotton, but it feels great. And just a tip there, whenever you're out thrift shopping, pick up white sheets, okay? Just do it. Pick up white cotton sheets when you see them. Trust me, you're gonna love me for it. If you don't turn things into them, you can use them for mock-ups. And this should be really simple and really basic. It's basically gonna be like a square. Okay, so I laid out my fabric, I put it in half, and I pinned along this seam to make sure it lays flat. Anyways, first off, I decided to make use of the natural thick, wide hem right here. I'm like, why take it apart? It's kind of nice for a petticoat to have a little structure at the end. That is not gonna hurt. I'm also gonna make use for these hemmed up things for the seam allowance. Why destroy something that's already hemmed, right? It'll save me time. Now, I measured my other petticoat and I found out that it was 38 inches. That's like the whole thing. And I'm like, you know what? I want this one a little bit shorter because that one has a propensity to drag a little bit. I don't think it will anymore since I added hooks and eyes, but I want this a little bit shorter. I just do. So I decided on going 2 inches shorter. So that's 36, so it's exactly a yard. And I am just gonna mark that out. Guys, our petticoat is near completion. Like I said, I just sewed the side seam, and then just because I used the hem of the sheet, I then hand sewed that down to make it look a little bit less like a hem. I also, like, this is such a lovely hem on the bottom. I also gathered the top, cut myself a waistband, and now all that's left is to whip stitch the reverse side down, add some hooks and eyes, and this lovely petticoat will be all ready to wear. And I am done. Like I said, this was pretty simple. I didn't really feel like I needed to film the whole thing. It's just your classic attaching hooks and eyes. I decided I was just gonna do one row, but it's always good for a sturdier fit to do two rows. So these just hook together like so. And hopefully create a nice strong bond. I know they're black, I'm just using one I have, so I know they don't match. Putting it out there. Okay, so this is done, which is fun. I feel like I'm actually cruising along on this mending stuff quicker than I thought, and I can't wait to try this on and see how the new fit is. But for now, I guess it's going to be on to the next project. Okay, guys, again, an evening project. We have one more thing to do, and then we are done. Last thing we're gonna do is be padding up the bodice of this dress to create, so there's like no weird gap here. It's gonna make this nice rounded shoulder shape, which was like really in the 1860s. You don't want any weird hollows. So that is gonna be our last thing to do, and I'm hoping to get it all done today. And it's pretty simple. We're gonna be using cotton batting. And you can pretty much find this anywhere. I mean, I honestly think it's like at any fabric store ever. And we're gonna be using some cotton batting to create a nice layer of padding for each side and give this dress a little bit more of a historical look. So what I'm just gonna do here, as you can see, it's a layer to create a nice smoothing over the hollow that my dress create. So the thing to do now is just to unpin this. I might round it out just a touch more and cut out one that matches. And now, time for the reveal. Now, I think for a really full work week that I was doing and then just cramming these into the evenings, I actually feel pretty satisfied with it. I am so happy with my new petticoat that I made, with the snaps I added to my old petticoat, with the bust padding. It just does hundreds for historical silhouette. And of course, this bonnet, which was one of the most pleasant surprises with just using steam and like some sugar water. So I hope you guys enjoyed following along, and although I didn't explain things into harsh detail, hopefully you kind of got the gist of it. Anyways, I hope this has kind of inspired you to go into your stash if you have like a project that's maybe just barely away from being finished, you know, just go tackle it. If you need to make an extra petticoat or some undersleeves or maybe something modern or not even anything to do with sewing, here is your sign and your motivation to just go get that done in the coming week. Okay, my name is Mindy Grace and you've been on my channel, Girl of a Different Era, where we are making our story history, one creation at a time. Bye guys.